Hello everyone, my name is Derek and welcome to the Netflix Know-How, the review show here to help you stop browsing and start watching. Today, we have Ice Guardians. Yeah, that's exactly what I think of when I think of the word guardian. Ice Guardians is a hockey documentary about the Enforcer. What is an Enforcer, you say? That guy, that's an Enforcer. They engage you through physical force. Enforcer. They're basically the bouncers of the hockey world. Now, I don't know a whole lot about hockey, but I do know it's about the closest thing you can get to a mixed martial arts fight on ice, and I can understand the appeal of that. Hockey is a sport that embodies brute physical strength and toughness, and nothing says tough like an Owen Wilson nose and a backwoods redneck smile. I always used to think that hockey players were just naturally angry people that wanted to punch everything in the face, but after watching this movie, I have to say they're actually a little bit more interesting than that. The whole point of the movie is to try and put a human soul behind the bruisers of the hockey world, and to that end, I do think that this movie does a pretty good job of that. Even though the movie is arguing in defense of keeping these hulking beasts in the league just so they can beat the snot out of anyone who gives them a funny look, it's really more about defending the camaraderie and the bonds that happen between teammates. The movie features interviews from players all over the league, from past and present, many of whom were enforcers in the past, and many other players who were also protected by these enforcers. See, the whole point of having an enforcer on your team is not just to assert your alpha dominance over the opponent. Well, not just that. As weird as this is to say, enforcers are kind of like peacekeepers who use their fists to defend the peace? Don't think about it too much. The point I'm trying to make, and the point that the movie is arguing, is that enforcers exist to protect their teammates from harm by laying the smackdown on anyone that tries to go after them. I didn't say it was a perfect system, but surprisingly it works. It's actually very interesting to see how the players view enforcers versus how the league views enforcers. It seems that this movie was made in a response to the NHL's decision to start cracking down on fights more strictly. In recent years, the NHL has been trying to rein in the amount of fights that happened in the league, much to the dismay of some fans, but to be fair, I understand their reasoning. They want hockey to be about hockey, the sport, the competition, the game, not some kind of back alley roadhouse brawl between adrenalized sacks of raging testosterone. I get it, I know why they are trying to crack down on this, but after watching this movie, I also understand why the players are in favor of enforcers. A lot of the interviews in the film are players talking about what it's actually like to be in the rink playing the game, where you're zooming up and down this sheet of ice with knives on your feet and what essentially amounts to a club in your hand. It's fast, it's crazy, and there's inevitably going to be some cheap shots along the way that lead to some pretty high tensions between players. Yes, there are referees and they are there to manage the game as best they can, but they can only do so much, and inevitably they are going to miss things sometimes. When the referees and the rule system fails, players a lot of the times would rather have teammates on their side who are going to back them up should things go south. In a way, having enforcers on your team is kind of like having a self-imposed way of enforcing the rules. As some of the interviewers mention, what's going to be more of a deterrent? 2 minutes in the penalty box or a broken jaw? Again, not a perfect system, and I'm not necessarily advocating for it, but I do get it. Overall, I do think that the film does a good job of offering arguments from both sides, although it definitely can feel a little more heavily biased towards the players because there's much more focus on them and nowhere near as much focus on the higher ups in the league who actually run the NHL. It was also very interesting to see and hear some of these players, men who have essentially made a career out of assaulting people on ice, and just sit there and listen to them as normal everyday people outside of the ring. There's a lot of mutual respect between players, and even if they were adversaries inside the rink, you can tell that they all respect each other and care for each other deeply outside of it. It's kind of like having siblings where you tend to fight and pick on each other a lot of the time, but at the end of the day, you still love each other. At least, that's how family is supposed to work, right? Unfortunately, the film does start to drag after about the hour mark. It felt like most of the main point that the film was trying to address had already been taken care of at that point, and afterwards it just kind of started to morph into this long-winded exploration and historical breakdown of hockey. There's nothing wrong with that per se, it's just that it wasn't the film that I had started watching, and it wasn't really the film I was interested in watching halfway through. It almost kind of felt like an essay that was trying to reach a certain word limit, and the author had already said everything he needed to say, and so the rest of it was just filled with fluff and padding to complete the runtime. I mean, the movie is an hour and 48 minutes, it's almost 2 hours. Do we really need a 2-hour movie about the importance of hockey enforcers? I think if it were about 30 minutes shorter, it would have been the perfect length, and it would have been able to stay focused on the subject matter while not losing any engagement. I did still find this to be a very interesting documentary, and considering that my knowledge of hockey basically starts and ends with the Mighty Ducks, that's a pretty good sign. If you're into hockey on any level, you're definitely going to enjoy this film. And even if you're not, it's still a very fascinating subject that I think anyone could enjoy. Thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate every single one of you. If you like this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. You can also head over to Twitter and over to Facebook and follow me on there. And as always, if you want to know your flicks, you know where to click. Happy hunting, guys. See you next time.